Everybody, it's Eric Johnson from Air Tate Throws Nation. In today's video, what we're going to talk about is rotational shot put. One of the things I'm proud about is our club record is a 17-foot PR in a single season from one season to next. So we had an athlete who was a sophomore and threw 45 feet in the glide, and we converted him to rotational shot, and he had a huge year and went 62-6, and that was enough to get him recruited and got him a college scholarship. So he had 17-foot PR. So what are some of the fundamentals that really help the rotational shot? And one of the core things is to understand that, of course, we have a smaller ring, the ball is sitting on top of us. So many people will teach the rotational throw very similar to the discus, but for scientific purposes and reasons, they just can't be the same. If you did the same technique and you have a 7-foot circle versus an 8-foot 2-inch circle, you are gonna run into problems. The ball is sitting on top of the center of mass instead of moving away. So there are some key fundamental differences, and we talk about that inside the throwing chain reaction in depth. So click the link below if you want some information on that. So today's video, what we're gonna talk about is the core basics to teach the rotational shot put. One of the core things we talk about in the rotational shot, just like the discus, we have a setup pattern and we have a sequence that's gonna help make the throw repeatable. So whether when you get into a stressful situation and you understand exactly how to set up your throw, you're gonna continue to throw further and you're gonna use that adrenaline. Big meet situations become your best friend because now that adrenaline amplifies your movement and you're gonna move faster. That's what's tricky about big meet competition. When you have those athletes that tend to not do so well, one of the reasons is because those errors that are not as big in a calm situation, once you get into competition, they're gonna go back up. And so now that error gets bigger and now the mistakes happen. And that's why you'll see so many athletes that will have a hard time competing versus throwing in a low key dual meet or in practice. So the core thing, like we talked about in the discus, one of the fundamental things you have to do with rotational throwing is get on balance. So what we teach in the throwing chain reaction system is how we're gonna set up a rhythm, and you're gonna notice when we show you that, you're gonna see that same type of rhythm. So we'll put up some of the top throwers in the world. Let's look at this last year's world championships and we'll look at our top four guys. You're gonna notice that same thing. They're gonna get up and they're gonna get on balance. Now, these four all have slightly different styles, and we would argue always mechanically, they're still hitting the six pillars of the throw. And that's a really important thing. So one of the core things that you're gonna notice is all these throwers, where's the sweep leg? And how is it moving out? It moves out slightly different than it would in the discus because the implement's here and it has to be a more rotational throw. So the first thing we do is we're setting up and we're getting in pillar one. So we're gonna be working on establishing balance. And as we shift, we're getting this arm out and it's gonna be opening wide and you're gonna notice the path of the sweep leg. And that's gonna be what we call pillar one, two, and three. This is the big trick in the throw. One, two, and then you're gonna see three, okay? And you're gonna notice how that movement will happen, and I'm pretty on balance, and this is where I can incorporate drills like 180s, 360s. Once an athlete understands the movement pattern of a 360, we'll do a lot less of them. We'll stick more to 180s and different things like that, but we do recommend that you do use the 360 drill. So again, that's gonna be, you're gonna notice when I'm here, and you're gonna notice how I'm coming around, and that's how it's gonna bring me back to my position. So you're gonna notice that my left arm tends to stay long. Some people will have athlete trying to hold the arm back. So if we're trying to optimize balance, if I hold the arm here, you're gonna notice the position. I can still do the 360 and you're gonna notice this versus look at this drill. When I do it here, you're gonna notice that I have a wider, longer path. Wider, longer path is gonna be really critical to throwing further. The point of this video is to start to give you some basic tips to understand the rotational throw better and understand that how you have to set up. So this is what we do with our throwing chain reaction system. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So what we have is a distinct difference in where we catch the how we catch the shot put and create separation in the rotational shot, more load on the legs so we can create more rotation. And the majority of rotational throwers tend to have a longer block arm so they can drive out. You've seen some throwers in history with the pulling in block. Ryan Krauser's one of them. But if you look at Tom Walsh, who has an amazing conversion from his stand throw to a full throw. If you look at Joe Kovacs, if you look at Darlin Romani, those are your top four guys in the world. Three of them all finish the same. And then if you look at the other finalists as well, you'll start to see the same thing. You see more of this type of a finish. The whole point of today's video is to kind of give you some insights into understanding that you have to set up balance and your whole start and how we're going to get around and how we're going to be moving and utilizing that left arm as a counter balance is going to be really key. The more you're on balance, and if you're somebody who's looking at this video and you don't know a lot about the throw, grab our free mini course below. We would highly recommend that. The more you can learn about the throw, the more you're going to get on balance. And so this is how we get our throwers to throw far. We teach them a system that it teaches them better balance. Better balance enables them to move through the throw more efficiently. And that's where we talk about six pillars. So again, we talk about a six pillar system. A chain reaction is critical. We have to set that up. We have to set up the movement that's going to help facilitate naturally all the rest of the movement in the throw. So again, the point of today's video is how are we going to improve big distance? How are we going to add 5, 7, 8, 10, 12, 17 feet? We have to be on balance. Rotational throwing is all about balance, and understanding the shot put is a more rotational throw in nature than the discus, because the implement is here and the ring is smaller. So by default, the path of the movement are going to change. So again, hopefully today's video, you found that helpful. If you have any comments, be sure to throw them below, and we will see you on the next video. And the thing I'm going to talk about today is perhaps the biggest trap that throwers fall into. This is what can cause conflicts between coach and athlete. Learn how to see and understand the throw, simplify the complexity. Be sure to click the link below for info on the throwing chain reaction system, and we will see you on the next video.